Senior Festival, with our Easter Lenten. Page 61 in our Book of Common Prayer. Thanks be to God who gives us the victory through our Lord Jesus Christ. As we remember our patron Saint George, with this great cloud of witnesses around us, therefore we too must throw off every encumbrance and the sin that all too readily restricts us, and run with resolution the race which lies ahead of us, our eyes fixed on Jesus, the pioneer and perfecter of faith. Blessed be the Lord our God.
By whose grace we are yet alive.
Blessed be his Son, Jesus Christ.
By whose rising we are set free.
Blessed be the Spirit of God. Father, we come together in the name of your Son, Jesus Christ, our Redeemer, to offer you our worship, praise, and thanksgiving. Of our sins. Have mercy upon us, most merciful Father. In your compassion, forgive us our sins.
Almighty God, have mercy upon you, pardon and deliver you from all your sins, confirm and strengthen you in all goodness, and keep you in life eternal, through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen. Psalm 126.
From the Word of God, written in Revelation chapter 12, beginning at verse 7. Revelation 12, 7 to 12. Now war arose in heaven, Michael and his angels fighting against the dragon. And the dragon and his angels fought, but they were defeated, and there was no longer any place for them in heaven. And the great dragon was thrown down, that ancient serpent, who is called the devil and Satan, the deceiver of the whole world. He was thrown down to the earth, and his angels were thrown down with him. And I heard a loud voice in heaven saying, now the salvation and the power and the kingdom of our God and the authority of his Christ have come, for the accuser of our brethren has been thrown down, who accuses them day and night before our God. And they have conquered him by the blood of the Lamb and by the word of their testimony, for they love not their lives even unto death. Rejoice then, O heaven, and you that dwell in therein. But woe to you, O earth and sea, for the devil has come down to you in great wrath, because he knows that his time is short. The word of the Lord.
Office in number 822. 822. 13.
A reading from the Word of God, written in 2 Timothy chapter 2, beginning at verse 3. 2 Timothy chapter 2, verse 3 to 13. Share in suffering as a good soldier of Christ Jesus. No soldier on service gets entangled in civilian pursuits, since his aim is to satisfy the one who enlisted him. An athlete is not crowned unless he competes according to the rules. It is the hard-working farmer who ought to have the first share of the crops. Think over what I say, for the Lord will grant you understanding in everything. Remember Jesus Christ, risen from the dead, descended from David, as preached in my gospel, the gospel for which I am suffering and wearing fetters like a criminal. But the word of God is not fettered. Therefore, I endure everything for the sake of the elect, that they also may obtain salvation in Christ Jesus with its eternal glory. The saying is sure, if we have died with him, we shall also live with him. If we endure, we shall also reign with him. If we deny him, he also will deny us. If we are faithless, he remains faithful, for he cannot deny himself. The word of the Lord.
We stand and sing the Nunc Dimittis.
That we may know the joy of your salvation.
grant peace within and among all nations.
And teach your leaders wisdom.
Endow your church with faithfulness.
And your servants with knowledge and true holiness.
Defend, O Lord, the rights of the poor and the oppressed.
Let your justice be known among all people.
Lord, renew your spirit within us. Almighty and everlasting God, who in the Paschal mystery established the new covenant of reconciliation, grant that all who have been reborn into the fellowship of Christ's body may show forth in their lives what they profess by their faith. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever. God of hosts, who so kindled the flame of love in the heart of your servant George, that he bore witness to the risen Lord by his life and by his death, give us the same faith and power of love, that we who rejoice in his triumph may come to share with him the fullness of the resurrection. Through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, who is alive and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever.
Amen.
Grant, Lord, that we may be faithful to you without turning aside, worship you without growing weary, serve you without failing, diligently seek you, happily find you, and forever possess you, the one and only God, blessed forever and ever.
Amen.
Lighten our darkness, Lord, we pray, and in your mercy defend us from all perils and dangers of this night. For the love of your only Son, our Savior, Jesus Christ. Tedium. 73, the prayer of dedication. Together, Almighty God, we thank you for the gift of your holy word. May it be a lantern to our feet, a light to our paths, and a strength to our lives. Take us and use us to love and serve all persons in the power of the Holy Spirit.
And in the name of your Son, Jesus Christ, the Lord.
Amen. May the God of hope fill us all with joy and peace in believing through the power of the Holy Spirit. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Let us bless the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Hymn number 832. 832.
Thank you.
without faith, it is impossible to please God. And without faith, it is impossible to please God. Words taken from Hebrews chapter 11 and verse 6. I speak in the name of God, whose Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Amen. Let me first of all take this opportunity to thank the Nichols and his parochial church council and members of the St. George's Cathedral for inviting me to address you on this, your feast day. I want to congratulate all who will be able to put this together to bring it to a reality. Without faith, it is impossible to please God. George's story has become a focus in the popular imagination of his dragon slaying exploit. And as such, he seems as the archetype hero who defeated evil. But there is more to him than just his legend. Although, as with many saints, facts are very sketchy, he stood up against the persecution of Christians in the 4th century. Because he was so disgusted by the barbaric methods employed by the emperor at the time, George was very impressed by the faith of those who died believing in Jesus, that he became a Christian himself. Even though he knew that this would certainly end in death. Christians are people who believe that the real power to overcome evil is from Jesus Christ, life, death, and resurrection. St. George knew this too. He knew this too well. He had seen how strong Christians had been facing persecution from the Roman Emperor. When he saw God's power at work, he became more loyal to his Lord, even though it meant death. And without faith, it is impossible to please God. As we read chapter 11 of Hebrews, we are introduced to a long list of persons who lived by faith and were happy and contented to live by faith. In fact, the writer presents these heroes of faith as a people powered by faith. I believe it is this fact that led the writer to make the transformative affirmation, and without faith, it is impossible to please God. As we reflect on the description of the people of God as a people powered by faith, the question that comes to mind is, what is powering our lives? What is the motivating factor that drives our lives and provides us with that energy to work and witness as disciples of Christ? The message of the Hebrew writer is that if faith is not the answer, we are seeking to do the impossible. Without faith, it is impossible to please God. For whoever would approach him must believe that he exists and that he reveals those who seek him. He rewarded those who seek him. As I reflect further on this theme, I examine two items in our daily living that have assumed high priority in the world. Firstly, I look at the motor car,
with special reference to the new models being offered with a wide variety of options. You may look and admire the popular model because of its general appearance and particular features offered. High musical sound system, state-of-the-art GPS, fully loaded, etc. It is amazing that all these features are useless without a functioning battery. It is the battery that enables the car to function as a car. Without a battery, it is impossible for the car to carry out its function. In a similar manner, I noted the attention paid to the various new feature smartphones on the market. Many of them offer more functions than many of us will ever be able to use. As I must confess that I am not up to date with the varieties of these smartphones and the wide arrays of functions which they have to offer, but I am learning daily. Despite the fact, I am aware that the number of varieties of functions are all dependent on the battery. Without a battery, it is impossible for the smartphone to function. The battery, in this case, of the smartphone and the motor car, occupies the place that faith enjoys in the practice of a Christian life. As we examine the present state of the church, we must examine the depth of our faith, the depth of our abiding personal trust and relationship with God. We must examine our reliance upon the one true and living God. As we engage in this exercise, we can use the picture of a smartphone and the motor car. We can pose the question to ourselves this afternoon: is my spiritual battery dead? Do I need to recharge my battery in this spiritual walk? If I am not being appropriately powered, I am failing to perform my Christian duties. If my battery is not charged, I am failing to perform my Christian duties. The same way the phone will not function unless it's recharged, the battery is recharged on a regular and systematic basis, the church offers three principal method for the recharging of our spiritual batteries. Firstly, regular engagement with the Holy Scripture. Our inner selves are empowered as we grow in the knowledge and understanding of God's message of love and hope. It is not sufficient to read the Bible or listen to the Bible being read to us daily. We must personally be engaged with the message that allows it to inform us, inform our total selves, our speaking, our feeling, our thinking, and our acting. Colossians chapter 3, verse 16 reminds us, Let the word of Christ dwell in you richly. The telephone is a material device. Our inner self is spiritual and must be fed with spiritual food. In this regard, the Bible is crucial for our well-being. The question is it crucial for you? Are you genuinely interested in recharging your spiritual battery by deepening your trust and dependency on God, who reveals his message to us in the Good Book, the Bible? This said message, George, your patron, was not afraid or ashamed to reclaim, to acclaim, and to proclaim. He did it fearlessly. Friends, If we want strong spiritual batteries, we will pay greater attention to God's word and genuinely seek to grow in the knowledge and understanding of God. Secondly, the church invites us to recharge our spiritual batteries through regular participation in worship and the commitment of our personal prayer life and devotion. We cannot recharge on our own power. That power must come from God, who invites us to worship Him in spirit and in truth. In reverence and in awe, pray without ceasing. And as we open ourselves to encounter His amazing grace. The spiritual recharge does not occur by accident. It requires an intentional offering of ourselves to God so that He may empower us. Without me, you can do nothing. As the disciples, we all must get ready. We all must get real about our worship and prayer life. If our spiritual batteries are to be fully charged for the Christian living. Thirdly, my sisters and brothers gathered here this afternoon, God wants us to recharge our spiritual battery, and He makes special provision for us as believers in the Holy Sacrament. With special attention to the Holy Communion, He wants for us to join here in faith so that He may bestow the spiritual power and energy that He requires to live the Christian life. Taste and see how gracious the Lord is. God wants to feed us in the Holy Communion as we receive the body and blood of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ by faith with thanksgiving. This nourishes, empowers, renewed us. It is a wonderful way in which God recharges our spiritual batteries on a regular and systematic manner. Week after week, we gather here to partake in that blessed sacrament. This afternoon, God is appealing through your patron, Saint George, to recharge your spiritual battery in order to defeat the several dragons you will encounter. Are we interested, or are we just going through the motion? The dragon of fear and hatred, the dragon of greed and self-centeredness, the dragon of violence and injustice, the dragon of oppression, are all still terrorizing our land, our people, our nation, our home. But George gives us the courage and the confidence to oppose and overcome them by the examples he set. Friends, we are here. We all have that potential. We can all achieve if we allow God to recharge our spiritual batteries and transform us into willing, cooperative, and enthusiastic workers for Him and for His kingdom. Let me never forget that without faith, it is impossible to please God. In the name of the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Amen.
could we give the dancers a special round of applause, too? We now announce the order of procession as set out in our leaflet. We start with the Cathedral Verger, the Thurifer and Boat Person, followed by the Crucifer and Acolytes, the other servers, the Sunday School, Scouts and Guides, other youth groups, and the Cathedral Youth Group, the AYM. They will be followed by the St. George's Cathedral Mothers Union branch with their banner preceding them, the banner of the St. George's Cathedral Mothers Union, and the other visiting Mothers Union branches will join in. They will be followed by the Communicants Association, the Men's Fellowship and Brotherhoods, and the Anglican Church Women Association, ACWA. Next would be the St. George's Cathedral Choir, followed by the Royal St. Vincent and the Grenadines Police Band. Next will follow the Cathedral Congregation with their banner of St. George, and they will be followed by the other visiting congregations, all other visiting congregations that we are pleased to have with us this afternoon. Following the visiting congregations, we'll have the Parish Church Council, then the visiting lay readers and Eucharistic assistants, followed by the Cathedral Eucharistic assistants. Next, we have the Cathedral lay readers, next the clergy, followed by the chapter crucifer, and the preacher for this afternoon's service, followed by the cathedral chapter. Finally, we have the torches, the MC, bishop's chaplain, and the bishop himself. Our people's warden, Mr. Louis Deschamps, he will guide you at the main